Hi, I'm Joel Hellman, Dean of the Walsh School of Foreign Service, coming to you socially distanced from my garden just a few blocks from campus. Welcome to Family Weekend 2020. Whether your parents, grandparents, brothers, sisters, or friends of the students of the School of Foreign Service, I know this is not how you hope to visit Georgetown this autumn. Our campus is as beautiful as ever, but it is eerily quiet. The pandemic has forced us to reimagine our community beyond the physical campus, and it has tested our resilience and resolve. Let me start first by acknowledging how difficult this has been on all of our students and on you, the family and friends who play such a critical role in supporting them. I know this is not the college experience that any of our students could ever have imagined, and I know that many of you share the pain of their disappointment. I won't sugarcoat these difficulties or, heaven forbid, talk about the silver linings of virtual learning. Our students are wrestling with a once-in-a-century challenge. Their character is being tested in unprecedented ways. I know this has been a struggle. But I also know that our students chose to come to this school, the SFS, because our very mission is to train leaders to confront the world's most pressing global challenges. Normally, we read about those challenges in books. Today, we're living them. Whether we are on campus or online, our SFS community is dedicated to marshaling expertise and innovation to prepare our students to solve global problems. And as difficult as this situation might be, that mission has never been more vital. Let me tell you all how we are working to fulfill that mission. Let me start by recognizing that our students are showing the kind of resilience that older generations often preach about. They are making online education work by being active participants in the virtual environment and by telling us how we can do better in using this platform. They are looking out for their peers who are having the toughest time adjusting and recognizing the deep inequities within our community that this pandemic has made so evidently clear. They're educating us on the realities of Zoom fatigue and suggesting remedies. As a result, SFS faculty have created a richer and more invigorating online classroom experience. And despite the fatigue of Zoom, students have engaged with genuine optimism and intensity. Our professors realized early on that online education both required and allowed them to take risks by expanding what was possible. In Professor Mark Giordano's seminar on water usage, for example, he was able to put students in direct conversation with an engineer in Sri Lanka who's growing and marketing traditional rice varieties, and a commercial fisherman and environmentalist in Washington State who had to Zoom from his car because he had no internet at home in the mountains. These students were themselves growing rice at home to learn in a hands-on manner. Professor Catherine Donato couldn't take the students in her class, immigrants, refugees in the state, to the Phillips Collection, so she used the museum's online resources to allow students to analyze Jacob Lawrence's famous series of panels on the Great Migration. For her international law class, Professor Liz Arsenault expanded interaction with a virtual Ask Me Anything feature borrowed from Reddit, monthly tea times for informal chats beyond the class subject, and then a peer mentorship program that connects young alums who previously took the class to current students. Even I've gotten into the action. I cajole the current president of the World Bank to drop into my online class on development in conflict-affected states. Where else but SFS can a small seminar of students grill the president of the World Bank on how he is leading in the face of a global crisis? One of the best things about being at Georgetown has always been that our DC campus is the gateway for so many incredible guests and critical conversations. We won't let this pandemic stop us. In fact, we've doubled down to ensure that we are hosting huge events with a truly global reach. Former Secretaries of State Madeleine Albright and Hillary Clinton commemorated the 25th anniversary of the groundbreaking speech in Beijing at the UN Fourth World Conference on Women. Dr. Anthony Fauci spoke directly to our students on the global affairs implications of the pandemic. Just weeks ago, we hosted a panel on the national security implications of the nation's reckoning with racism, diversity, and inclusion. And throughout the semester, I've been holding smaller events that put students in direct conversation with SFS alumni who are showing how to lead through the current crisis. They've had great off-the-record discussions with the CFO of The Gap, the CEO of a major Fortune 500 tech company, the CEO of the Catholic Medical Mission Board, and even Kai Rizdal, the inimitable host of NPR's Marketplace. your students have been doing their part as well, creating social engagements for each other. The SFS Academic Council has run the first of several SFS trivia nights, creating teams of friends, old and new, competing for prizes. And they've put together dinner chats as well, all using the computer. As challenging as this semester has been for all of us, what I take away is a tremendous admiration and respect for the spirit and resilience of our students. You know, the SFS was created just over a century ago in the aftermath of another great global crisis, World War I, and another once-in-a-century pandemic, the Spanish flu. Our founder, Father Edmund A. Walsh, realized then that the school, in response to such cataclysms, had to do more than just educate. It had to foster what he called a great soul, a great heart, and a great mind. Our students are indeed face to face with a challenge of the soul, a challenge of the heart, and a challenge of the mind. I'm inspired by their examples. They give me hope that this next generation will make progress in confronting global challenges where we have failed. This should give you hope as well. And at a time like this, we all need it. We welcome you into the Georgetown community, and we hope you see this weekend what our students can achieve in the face of such adversity. Stay well, and thank you.